Hi guys, my name is Chubby. Welcome to our next installment of Duo It All. Today we take on the last wing of the Scarlet Monastery, the Cathedral. As always, I'm looking forward to your feedback, so please leave a comment in the comment section below. So let's get started. This dungeon has three bosses, starting with High Inquisitor Fairbanks and ending with a double boss fight of Scarlet Commander Mokraine and High Inquisitor Whitemane. There's only one quest left for the Scarlet Monastery as a whole, and that's the last part of Into the Scarlet Monastery, for which we have to kill Mokraine and Whitemane. The dungeon has two major sections, the gardens and the cathedral itself. The garden is not very important and a lot of trash is skippable, but it does look beautiful. Now the cathedral part is the meat of this dungeon. To fight against Mokraine and Whitemane, we have to kill every single trash mob in here or we will add on the Mokraine pool. And once again we overpulled and fought like 4 mobs at once, or rather in direct succession, instead of 2 groups of 2 mobs. But because a lot of the mobs in here are reused from the library and the armory, their levels are quite low, making this a lot easier than I anticipated. On that thought, as far as I know, there are only 2 new mob types in this dungeon. The Scarlet Champions, which are quite weak but have one special striking ability that deals considerable damage, and the Scarlet Abodes, which are quite annoying as they heal, renew and enrage. The entire cathedral can be easily done by only ever pulling groups of 2 mobs. There are only 2 groups in total where you are required to fight 3 mobs at once, so as long as you interrupt the heals and purge the shields, slash hots and don't overpull, you should be fine. Now here is one example of the weird interaction with Ravager and Windfury. You can sort of store Windfury procs while spinning with the Ravager proc and then unleashing it all the moment you stop spinning. As you just saw, I hit that mob 4 times the moment I stopped spinning, and here it happened again. This interaction doesn't seem to work very often and I'm not sure how it does work. My best guess would be that if Windfury procs multiple times while spinning and you don't get an additional Ravager proc, you will unleash all the proc Windfuries at once and annihilate the target. But I'm not sure, and I'm not even sure if the Windfury even stacks or if it's just laggy. If any of you guys witnessed something similar while playing with this weapon, please let me know in the comments below. Now this is one of the packs with 3 mobs, focus down the monks first and don't make the same mistake as I do and heal while in melee range of said monks, as they can interrupt you. I just got really lucky here. So off to Fairbanks, this guy casts a few abilities. He heals himself, he shields himself and he puts you to sleep, so put down a tremor totem. But his most important ability is Curse of Blood. Always try to interrupt it or put down a grounding totem, as this curse greatly increases physical damage taken and lasts a whooping 10 minutes. Now we didn't really wanna wait 10 minutes for the curse to fade, so we just ignored it and went for Mokraine, who was surprisingly easy, so enjoy the fight. And that's challenge completed. We managed to 2-man the entire Scarlet Monastery without dying once. But now let's take a look at the results. We made a total of 26,000 experience, including the quest, which translates to roughly 1/3 of a level at level 40. This doesn't look like much, but we cleared the dungeon in about 33 minutes, so we made almost 50,000 experience per hour. Not too bad if you ask me. We got some pretty sweet loot for me with the Triune Amulet and the Gauntlets of Divinity. And I hope you enjoyed this run as much as we did, and I see you next week in Zul'Farrag. There the difficulty really ramps up a notch. Also, we will skip Ulduman for the series, as it inherently can't be done with two people, as you need to have at least three people activating the two altars at the end of the dungeon. Thank you for watching, goodbye.